I remember when the Panthers selected Christian McCaffrey with the 8th overall pick, some people were kind of doubting it, saying you shouldn't pick a running back with that high of a pick. However, if there is a running back worth getting drafted with a top 10 pick, Christian McCaffrey is definitely one of those guys. One of the things that makes him so effective isn't just his talent, but how the Panthers use him. Like on this play, for example. As you see, the Panthers are going to fake as though it could be a quarterback option play to the top half of the screen. And since that's a play they run pretty frequently, now a Bengal is going to have to be aware of that. They're also then going to pull a tight end and right guard over to the left side of the screen to take away the Bengals' two linebackers on this play. Now for this play to work, it's going to be a run to the left side of the field, meaning one of the key blocks is going to be left guard Greg Van Rotten. But as you see, he does a very good job blocking, and all the Panthers do a very good job blocking, meaning McCaffrey is able to get past that initial burst at the line of scrimmage. Since typically the only way to get past the line of scrimmage is to be running in one direction, that's exactly what McCaffrey did, and he's running straight forward. Now the Bengal, who's in the best position to try to tackle McCaffrey, is going to move to the top half of the screen, because that's where McCaffrey's momentum is taking him. However, McCaffrey's instead going to cut to the bottom half of the screen. This is going to allow him to get past that safety, and he ends up picking about 30 more yards because of it. I think it's a great example of showing how the Panthers draw up plays to allow McCaffrey to get down the field, and then McCaffrey's able to take advantage of that and pick up even more yards. While that was an example of when a play call worked, it was able to help McCaffrey, let's talk about a play where a play call didn't work and wasn't able to help McCaffrey. Really, the whole point of this play is for the Panthers to try to fake as though it's going to be a run to the left side of the screen. So to do that, first they're going to have a tight end on that left side of the screen. They're then going to have their center have a one-on-one matchup with a Bengals interior lineman, and then they're going to double team the Bengals interior lineman on the left side of the screen. They're also going to have their right tackle have a one-on-one matchup on the Bengals edge rusher on the right side of the screen, and they're going to pull their right guard over to the left side of the screen. The whole point of this play is to get those Bengals linebackers moving to the left side of the screen, and then McCaffrey can run to the right side of the screen and just get past them. However, that doesn't really work out. The Bengals weren't really fooled. As you see, a linebacker is still lined up perfectly with McCaffrey, and they have another defensive back who's now moved over to the right of McCaffrey who could help contain McCaffrey. You'd see a lot of running backs run to the right here to try to get in between those guys, and you probably would get tackled, but could maybe pick up another 3 or 4 yards. However, look at McCaffrey on this play. He's going to fake as though he's going to the right, but then instead go to the left. As you see, the linebacker now trying to make a tackle sort of has to lunge at him and can't tackle him with his legs. He sort of has to try to tackle him with his arms, which he isn't able to do, and McCaffrey's able to break the tackle and run for some more yards. As the old saying goes, it's up to an offensive coordinator to make things easier for the offense. But even though that wasn't able to happen on this play, McCaffrey was still able to take advantage of the play not working out very well and was still able to pick up some yards. This next play is another interesting one. As you see, the Falcons are going to be playing a cover one hole, and McCaffrey's going to be breaking to the top half of the screen, meaning that the guy in charge of following him will also be breaking up in that direction. So typically you think, okay, great. Throw it to McCaffrey and it comes into a foot race, where he's going to try to race to the sideline, and if he can get past that linebacker, it could be very good news for Carolina. However, that's not exactly what's going to end up happening. I'm going to cut to another angle, but as you see, McCaffrey has the ball, and you expect him to continue running towards the sideline. That's what Deion Jones is expecting as well, who's a great player, so he doesn't get fooled too often. But he's running to that left side of the screen, and what McCaffrey's going to do is simply break back in. This is now going to allow him to get past Jones and get to the first down marker. This is just a great play by McCaffrey. He's able to not just know what's going on, but also uses athleticism to get past Jones. While he is talented enough to just use his sheer talent to get past a lot of people, what I think really makes him even better is that he's able to use his intelligence and his talent to then get past people, like on this play for example. Carolina's going to have their tight end and left tackle move up to have one-on-one matchups on the two Falcons who are on the line at the bottom half of the screen. They're then going to have their right tackle on the top half of the screen move up to block a linebacker on the top half of the screen, and then they're going to send their other three offensive linemen down to the bottom of the screen to lead block for McCaffrey. The whole point of a play like this is it allows you to not have to block a defensive end, and then the other three Falcons who are in that area would then get blocked by the three Panthers who are pulling over to the bottom half of the screen. However, take a look at Sherrod Neesman on this play. He's going to do a good job of breaking to the outside, which is now going to force a Panther to have to block him towards that side. This now means that if McCaffrey continues to run towards the sidelines, it's going to give Atlanta a lot more time to have a guy get off his block and eventually get to McCaffrey. However, McCaffrey looks around and sort of sees what's going on. Obviously, everything's going so quick for McCaffrey, he's not able to realize every single little detail that I'm pointing out here. However, he does realize that there's two Falcons getting blocked right there. You wouldn't be able to see a lot of backs do this, as they wouldn't have the speed to get past everyone here. However, McCaffrey does have that speed, and he's able to be aware and know that that's where the hole is that he can get through. It wasn't exactly the perfect situation for the Panthers, but in the NFL, you're going to be going against defenses who have players who can make big plays. And it's up to you to be able to realize that they're making a good play, and be able to counteract it and make a good play of your own. But McCaffrey was able to do that on that play, and in fact, he does it on a lot of plays. And it's a huge reason he's one of the best in the league.
some you feel. And you know, and you know, and you know, real.